Good morning, all. This is the Bucknuts Morning 5. I'm Dan Rubin. Got a good show planned for you today. Going to talk about J.F. Thomas, the receiver from Texas. Going to talk about Texas recruiting in general. Going to pass along some information about a prospect we are told is being fast-tracked when he arrives on campus. Going to go into some of the details of the new college football playoff selection committee process and give you a little preview of what we have coming up on the site today. Yesterday, there was an interesting development with an offer to a player from Texas, broken by 24/7 Sports national recruiting analyst Ryan Bartow. Let's go to him right now for that news.
This is Ryan Bartow from 24/7 Sports, reporting that Ohio State Buckeye offensive coordinator Tom Herman was in Dallas, Texas on Wednesday morning and offered three-star wide receiver J.F. Thomas. Thomas, a 6'5", 185-pounder, is currently a TCU commit. He also has offers from Maryland. Thomas called this offer from the Buckeyes a, quote, game changer. He's a recruitment that we'll track going forward. For the latest on Ohio State Buckeye recruiting and J.F. Thomas, stay tuned to 247sports.com.
We thank Ryan for chipping in. We now know that the offer is not a committable one. He'll have to come here and camp this summer. But we've also had people since look at his film and say that is not a guy who should be ranked outside the top 100 in Texas. He's young to the sport. And for more on J.F. Thomas, I'd also check out Bill Kerlick's Buzz this morning. What's come to light now with the addition of JT Barrett and the recruitment of J.F. Thomas that could be starting, and also Bill Kerlick reporting that the number one outside linebacker in the country, Malik Jefferson, out of Texas, is that the Lone Star State has become a much more central focus in Ohio State's recruiting. I think that's a fantastic development. Does it mean they're going to get guys like Tony Brown, the number one corner in the country last year, who ended up at LSU but was looking at Ohio State late in the process? There's no guarantee you'll be able to go in there and get the top players in the state, but a repeated emphasis on the state can do nothing but help Ohio State's national profile. Got to be big in Florida, got to be big in California, got to be big in Texas. If you can do that on top of the way Ohio State has done in the Midwest traditionally and how they're expanding on in the Mid-Atlantic, we can expect these recruiting classes to finish ranked in the top five consistently as we move ahead under the Herb era. If you're a fan of the Bucknuts 90 on Sunday, and let's face it, who isn't, you'll often hear us talk about guys we expect to come in out of the 2013 class that have yet to arrive, and a lot of things are expected of. And a name that comes up a lot is Eric Smith, the safety out of Glenville. Wasn't the most highly touted prospect during the recruiting process, but I can tell you this. Here's a guy we hear about consistently from sources close to the staff that he could play a major role early on in his Ohio State career. We've heard it off and on from people. Yesterday we heard from a source very connected to the staff, and the term they used for Eric Smith was fast track, meaning they're going to try and get him ready to play as soon as possible. Does that mean he steps in and starts? Absolutely not. I would think that would be a complete long shot, but you never know who's going to get injured. We need depth at safety, that's clear. Von Bell stepped up and then got injured. You can expect Eric Smith to be a name that once he hits spring camp that we'll be keeping a real close eye on. Big expectations for the hard-hitting safety out of Glenville. Okay, finishing up here, if you'd like to take a look at the College Football Playoff Selection Committee details that were released yesterday, we put a complete copy of the press release on the site in the front row. Pretty interesting stuff. It's clear they're trying to be transparent about it, but there are some loopholes in there that makes it seem as if your school is represented on the committee, it may work in your favor. Things to look for on the site today. Get over right now and read Kerlick's Buzz for the latest on Malik Jefferson, the outside linebacker out of Texas. Coming later today, you'll get Jay Book's latest look outside Columbus, the boarding house. And tonight in the NBA, you can follow your lone Buckeye in action. That is Evan Turner as he and the Indiana Pacers attempt to stave off elimination, being the number one seed, playing at the Atlanta Hawks, down 3-2. Turner's trade to Indiana has not gone very well. His performance in the playoffs hasn't gone well at all. With him entering free agency, this would be a good night for Evan to kind of step up and show what he can do. Why don't you have a great day, Bucknutters.